Let's look at composite figures. Okay, composite figures. The volume of a rectangular prism. Oh, it says find the volume of the composite figure round to the nearest tenth. So what kind of figures do we have? Well, at first you might say, that's a pyramid and a prism on the bottom. But be careful. The top is also a prism because it's got parallel bases, but the bases just happen to be triangles. So what you're going to do is you're going to find the area of the rectangular prism on the bottom. And we know that one's easy. It's length times width times height. So let's do that. Length times width times height. So that's going to be 8 times 4 times 5. And that's going to be 40 times 4, which is 160. Okay? So 160 cubic centimeters. Now let's find the volume of the regular triangular prism. This triangle right here, okay? Do you see how they're parallel to each other? And that's how you can tell. Okay, so we've got to find the area of an equilateral triangle, don't we? Oh, we did that in the warm-up. So let's draw our altitude down. We know that cuts that into 4 and 4. And remember the rule, this is a short leg, this is the long leg. So that is 4√3. So let's find the area. It's 1/2 the base. Well, we're going to use the whole base of the triangle, 1/2 of 8 times the height, which is 4√3. So 1/2 of 8 is 4, and 4 times 4 is 16√3. So that is now my base area. So base area times the height. Well, now the height is this part, right? Because here's my parallel side. So times 5, and what's 16 times 5? I believe that's 80, isn't it? Okay, yeah, 80. So that's going to be 80√3 cubic centimeters. Okay, now, here are my two volumes. I'm putting them together, so I'm going to add them. Now, can I add these together? Not in the form they're in, so there's your answer in exact form. Now, if you have a decimal form, you can go ahead and type it out as 160 plus 80 and put in the √3, and it should give you the decimal answer. So the decimal answer is 298.6 cubic centimeters. But if you want the exact, because we'd have to round this off, so that one's not exact. Here's the exact answer. So if you're asked for exact answers, leave them as radicals. And if you're asked for estimated, you write it as a decimal. Okay, let's look at a couple more of these composite figures. Okay, this next composite figure is a rectangular prism topped off with a cylinder. But what do you notice about the cylinder? The cylinder is only half of a cylinder. So let's look at this rectangular prism, and then we're going to have to figure out that cylinder part. So the rectangular prism is going to be length times width times height, or 9 times 11 times 6. So 99 times 6 is 500 and what? Something almost 600. 6 short of 400, right? 594 cubic millimeters. Okay, so that part's easy, the rectangular prism. Now let's look at the cylinder. Okay, cylinder's volume is pi r squared times height. But what are we going to do with that cylinder since we only have half of it? We're going to divide it by 2. Okay, so let's go back and figure out our radius and our height. Okay, what's the radius of this cylinder? It's half of this side, isn't it? Okay, so this is 9, and this is 9, so it's going to be 4.5. So that's going to be 4.5 squared. And now the height is this height, which is 11. Then we're going to take all that divided by 2. So let's crank this out. Let's see, 4.5 squared. That's going to give me 20.25 times 11. That's going to give me 222.75 pi divided by 2. So let's just divide that coefficient by 2. And that's 111.375. And I still have my pi in there. Okay. So that is the volume of that cylinder part. Now we've got to take these two and do what? Add them together. So I've got 594 plus 111.375 pi. Now, we usually round to tenths, so I'm going to round that 3 to what? A 4. So 594 plus 111.4 pi. And because that has a pi, I can't add them together, and I just stick my units with it, which is millimeters cubed. And there we go.